The next one, you might hear me saying simplify, because I got another one, 2015-11, simplifying the measurement of inventory. Today, inventory is measured at the lower cost or net realizable value. So there was a lot of work to determine whether you're at the ceiling or above the floor on your net realizable value. So the FASB decided that you would just use that lower of measurement on a go-forward basis. Okay, so I think it's a lot easier to apply. It's important to note that they did not amend basically go forward. This is really just the impairment side of inventory. So if you're using LIFO or if you're using FIFO or average cost method, you continue to use that. But on an impairment analysis, you would just now have to look at the lower of cost or net realizable value. It is important to note on this one that this one, the change in this one did make it comparable with IFRS or the ISB's version of impairment for inventory. The next one, this one's probably better to describe as a picture rather than words, but 2016-18 talks about how I'm going to deal with restricted cash in the presentation of my cash flows. Today, we have a reconciliation of beginning and ending cash and cash equivalents. Bottom line, in the future, you're not going to include restricted cash in that. So I gave you an illustration. You'll see there at the bottom, we're going to have a reconciliation. Before, I just had cash, cash equivalents. Now I got cash, cash equivalents, and restricted cash. So that really is the difference.